Hey, this is Joel with Midwest Hunting and Outdoors by Two Dumbass Podcast. Thanks for watching. This is the final part of how we make our podcast. So in this episode, we're going to talk about the tips and tricks and little things that we've learned along our journey. So hope you've appreciated and liked this episode. If you do like what we're doing, you know, hit the like button and tell some friends. Thank you.
Hi, this is Tim and Dole. Welcome to Midwest Hunting and Outdoors by Two Dumbasses, a podcast about the outdoors, hunting, and being a steward of the land.
Hey, if you like what these two dumbasses are doing, please hit the like button and subscribe today.
Okay, we would love to hear any comments or questions that you have. Please write down below in the comments section. Also, you know, let's share some learnings here. So, like I said earlier, we've been at this for a couple years and over 100 videos now. Some tips and tricks is I would encourage you to at least write out your thoughts. That could be in the form of a storyboard with pictures or just on a piece of paper. You can see that I've just so when you get into this that you hit the key notes that you want and get the messages sent that you'd want to do. Storyboards are super helpful. They can link up what shots you're going to take to send that message the best you possibly can. And then one of the things we found early, because we're videotaping on cameras and then we've got a separate unit, which means a separate SD card, separate tracks for audio, we've got to link them up so they're on top of each other and it looks good and sound good. So when I say hello, hello matches my lips moving. And the best way we found to do that is just count one, two, three, and clap at the beginning of the podcast, and then that allows the editor, which is me, to link up that audio to the video, and you can actually see it jump in the audio tracks. And again, I'll include this little video snippet of from Filmora how I sync it together. So,
two, three.
That's really helped us out. That was took us a lot of time before we figured that out. The other thing when you're doing your podcast, make sure you understand what you have to have and what's nice to have. So I don't think we've done a podcast where a battery hasn't gone dead. We forgot to turn on the Zoom recorder and we had to use the camera mic. One of the cameras failed, but we were able to use the other camera. So again, having a backup of a backup is always good, and more times than not you're gonna be thankful that you have some kind of plan B when you're doing your podcast. We think it's important that you have fun with your podcast. I think it comes through in the podcast and the editing and the sessions themselves. And make it your own. Everybody has their own style. We'd encourage you to watch our videos, and we've kind of kept the same style, and which is having fun and having a lot of yucks and laughs while we do the podcast, and somewhat informal. But we've had a lot of guests on, and got a lot of meet a lot of people, and really had a lot of fun with it. So make sure you have fun with this, and don't take it too serious. Coming down to the last thoughts here is we spent probably several months, 3 months, maybe even talking through it, doing research on equipment. And, you can spend a lot of time talking about this and researching it, but there comes a point where you just got to go do it. So I would just encourage you if you want to do a podcast, you know, just go do it and grow with it. If that's equipment wise, grow with it or scene or topics or whatever it is, just grow with it and have a lot of fun. That's the approach we took. We probably should have started a little bit earlier in ours, but there's a point where you just have to start pedaling the bicycle and go for it. The other thing is we reached out to to people that were doing podcasts. So there's a whole wealth of information out there that if you're thinking about doing a podcast, feel free to reach out to us with questions. We reached out to a couple folks that were doing podcasts when we were thinking about doing one, and it really helped us with equipment and answering some questions that we had. YouTube is a great source for information out there, and then just friends and family. So don't be afraid to go out and ask for help and have fun with your podcast. Hey, thanks for watching our podcast. Hit the like button and subscribe. Our number one question that we get from our audience is, how do I know when you got a new episode out? Well, if you were a subscriber, you will get notified on your computer or your phone, however you're hooked up, from YouTube saying that the two dumbasses have a new episode out. So if you hit the subscribe button, it's a big advantage for you and it really helps us out. So thank you for watching today. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope you like the podcast. Again, if you have any questions about how we approach it or anything that I said here and wanted some follow-up, let us know. But until then, be safe, have fun, and get outdoors. Thanks for listening or watching our show. We have some exciting topics and guests coming up.
We ask that you subscribe to our channel on YouTube and follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.
We look forward to hearing your suggestions for topics,
questions, and comments. This is Two Dumbasses signing off. Until next time,
be safe,
have fun, and get outdoors.